Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Adiv Glair. Aina Urika, Aina Ushul Glair, Valum Valtica Roit, Arduus Kug, Shavannis Fronte, Daf Bakhtini, New Institute. Fronfer, Damakten, Arbjogan Mila Makleninov, Agus Gowan Korgardis Lagakina Ako, Rong Kema Nablina 2018. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, let me begin by welcoming you to the Institute's conferring of awards ceremonies. In particular, I would like to ask, or sorry, like to welcome, even our graduates, you, the invited guests, our special guest speaker this afternoon, Professor Edmund Harty, members of the Institute's governing body, the members of the Institute's Academic Council, the staff of the Institute, and the Institute's invited guests. Almost 1,000 graduates will be conferred with an award across three different ceremonies today, and congratulations to each and every one of you, the graduation class of 2018. I would now like to introduce the platform party to you. Firstly, my name is Brendan O'Donnell. I'm the Vice President of Academic Affairs and Registrar of the Institute. On my left is Dr. Joseph Walsh, Head of School of Science, Technology, Engineering and Maths. Dr. Noel Mulligan, the Head of Department of Biological and Pharmaceutical Sciences. Dr. Patrick Carney, Head of Department of Technology, Engineering and Maths. Dr. Michael Hall, Head of Department of Health and Leisure Studies. Dr. Eilish Broderick, Head of Department of Science, Technology, Engineering and Maths. Mr. Seamus O'Shea, Head of School, Health and Social Sciences. Mr. Terry O'Brien, Governing Body of IT Tralee. And Dr. Oliver Murphy, President of IT Tralee. So, to open the formal ceremony, I now call upon Mr. Terry O'Brien to do the formal opening. Thank you.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. I'm delighted to be here today on behalf of the governing body. This is the best day of the year for the IT. This is where, our graduands become graduates. And really, it's as I said, it is the day that we all look forward to. To our graduands, congratulations. Don't look so nervous, it's all over now. You can't fail now unless you stumble coming across the stage. And don't forget that. I want to congratulate you all. I want to assure you that we as an IT are so proud of you. We are here for you, and we will be here for you in the future. I spoke with some of the graduands, and they asked me to inform their parents of a few things that went on through the year. They asked me to explain RAG Week, and to inform you that that in Kerry, RAG Week is a week of reflection and prayer. You may have heard of venues such as the Abbey for prayer. The Castle is for heritage. The Blasket is for the Irish language, etc. And Hennessy's is reflection. Lots of reflection. They've also asked me to ensure all their parents and guardians here today that as in from today, you will not be asked for any more money. It's called payback time. That's what I thought. Wasn't that what you said, no? Okay. On behalf of the governing body also, I'm delighted at this time. It's a very exciting time for our institute. We are pushing ever closer to MTU status, the Munster Technological University, where we will be joined with CIT in Cork and become a university, which is hugely important for us. This will probably be our last year in the Brandon Hotel. Next year, I would imagine, we'll be in our 18 million euro sports development in the North Campus, which we are very, very proud of. And we have lots of things ongoing in IT Tralee that we are extremely proud of. To the graduands, the outfits, the heels and the hair colours are spectacular. And ladies, you look well as well. it's your day. You'll be shortly become graduates, and I'm sure you have plans for tonight. We're back to the prayer and reflection. I'll take it, and I ask you to enjoy your day. On behalf of the governing body, thank you for choosing IT Tralee. As I said, you are our ambassadors, and I hope you and your family and friends enjoy your day. Thank you very, very much.
Thank you, Terry. We now come to the conferring of awards. Dr. Oliver Murphy, President of the Institute, will confer the awards while the relevant head of department calls the graduates forward to receive the awards. Probably as a mark of a booming economy, a lot of our graduates, unfortunately, not have been able to make it here today because they're in employment, but we will still acknowledge their graduation by graduating or conferring them in absentia. So I now call upon Dr. Oliver Murphy, the President of the Institute, to confer the awards.
Our county institute, August the Harava and Udrash, a Harlinga Eri, Dom Carlocti, Brunham Davoctani, Auramori, the institute, a Tar Teresh and Kaidan, Kinna Egan Gorla, the Davoctani Shane of Wintermark, August Irim, Gogwerfer, the Fowler Shane, in Molahar, Conapar, a Hortoiv, go for a mule. On behalf of the institute, and by virtue of the authority delegated to it under the Qualifications and Quality Assurance Act, I hereby confer awards on the learners of the Institute who have achieved the standard determined by the Council for those awards, and I ask that those learners be presented to me so that I may formally present them with their parchment.
I now ask Dr. Noel Mulligan, Head of Department of Biological and Pharmaceutical Sciences, to call the graduates who are to be conferred.
Good afternoon. President, I now present the following candidates who have successfully completed the requirements for a certificate, degree, or honor degree with the Department of Biological and Pharmaceutical Sciences, and who are worthy to have these awards conferred upon them. So starting off with the Higher Certificate in Science in Biological and Environmental Studies, Rebecca Duan. Catherine Hannafin. Higher Certificate in Science in Pharmaceutical Analysis with Environmental Science, Norma Murray. Bachelor of Science in Pharmaceutical Analysis with Forensics, Maria Moriarty. Nicola Trainer. Bachelor of Science in Pharmaceutical Science, Shane Barry. Thomas Collins. Jenny Griffin. Jackie King. And P. Shee Tan. Bachelor of Science Honours in Pharmaceutical Analysis with Forensics, Clarence Kennedy. Lok Yuan Liang. Aoife Moriarty. Bachelor of Science Honours in Wildlife Biology, Enda Buckley. David Crowley. Kira Dolan. Rob Denise. Ian Egan. Paula Farrell. Mark Fitzgibbon. Cassandra Gleason. Cahal Kegery. Danny Keung. Stephen Kingston. Donica McGeever. David McGillicuddy. Christine Meehan. Luke Myers. Brian O'Connor. Paddy Power. Paddy 2-1 the field. Sive Quinn. Jane Sheehan. Rachel Toher. Bachelor of Science Honours in Field Biology with Wildlife Tourism, Justine Augustin. Ruth Buckley. Michelle Duggan. Kira O'Sullivan. Bachelor of Science in Agricultural Science, John Burns. Dara Carroll. Rachel Clancy. Alan Falvey. Fabian McCarthy. Rachel McNamara. Chloe Murphy. Gareth O'Connor. Rachel Rogers. Rosha Rothwell. Kelly Salmon. Bachelor of Science Honours in Agricultural Science, Katrina Crowe. Amy Farrell. Gráinne Gilsonen. Fionnuala Godwin. Sean Hayes. Aaron Healy. Ian Kennedy. Shane Lennon. Owen McCarthy. Susan Maloney. Padraig Mulcrony. Lisa Murphy. Laura O'Connell. Padraig O'Driscoll. Sarah O'Mara. Liam Whitford. Now, we've come to the postgraduate awards. I now present the following postgraduate candidates for their awards. President, I ask you to confer on behalf of the Quality and Qualifications Ireland the award of Masters of Science by Research to Patrick Delan. His thesis, Assessment of Clinical and Blood Gas Parameters in Healthy and Diuretic Calves. His supervisors were Dr. Gerard Sayers, who is accompanying him onto the platform, Rena Sayers, and Dr. Leah Crump. Masters of Science by Research to Derek Gombelza. Derek's thesis was in vitro three-dimensional skin tissue constructs supervised by Dr. Joanna Tierney and Dr. Tim Yeomans, and accompanied onto the platform here by Joanna Tierney and Bridget Breen. Beg your pardon. If I haven't it written down, I'm in trouble. Okay, thank you.
Thank you, Noel. I'd now ask Dr. Patrick Carney, Head of Department of Technology, Engineering and Maths, to call graduates who are to be conferred.
Thank you, Brendan. President, I now present the following candidates who have successfully completed the requirements for certificate, degree, or honours degree within the Department of Technology, Engineering and Maths, and who are worthy to have these awards conferred upon them. Bachelor of Engineering in Civil and Environmental Engineering, Ali Barry, Connor Coonahan. Daniel Keane. Daniel Juan Lowe. Stephen McHenry. Stephen Moriarty. Michael O'Connor. Shane Reen. Bachelor of Science Honours in Construction Management, Justin McCarthy. Bachelor of Engineering in Agricultural Engineering, Pori Gahern, Andrew Bonham, Ben Buckley, John Carter, John Connolly, Tim Cardon, Stephen Healy, Owen Hennessy, Connor Holton, Brian Joyce, Jason Kelly, Thomas Lacey, Robert Langan, Cathal Lahan, John Madden, Andrew Moffat, and Seamus Tuberty. Bachelor of Science Honours in Agricultural Engineering, Boyce Claxton, Paul Donegan, Paul also received the award earlier this morning for the John Deere Award of Achievement. Patrick Finnegan. Patrick Heffernan. James Lenehan. Christopher Maris, Bobby O'Shea, Mark Phelan. Shane Swanick. And Matthew Wilson. Bachelor of Science in Agricultural Mechanization. Keith Broderick. Padraig Carroll. Glenn Condell. Gavin Doherty. Gerard Donovan. Connor Fay. Shane Flanagan. Fergal O'Mar. Billy Murphy. Scott O'Riordan. Thomas O'Rourke. Thomas also achieved an award this morning, the FTMTA Award of Achievement. And David Tracy. Bachelor of Engineering in Manufacturing Engineering. Vita Chandrakar. Balakandran, Niall Byrne, Farah Balkia, Mateus Bute, Murty Bryan, Go. Chow, Timmy Foley, Graham Forn, Shane Hannafin, Awang Ikram, Adrian Kassan, John Kinsler. John was presented with the Patrick Flynn Engineering Award this morning. Michael Lyons. Brian O'Riordan. Michael O'Sullivan. Edward Oon, Mong Peng, Praveen Ranjan, Rexy Tobias, Daniel Ting, Ruben Willis. And Jude Talen. Bachelor of Engineering in Mechanical and Electronic Engineering, Kevin Casey. Bachelor of Science Honours in Manufacturing Engineering. Con Cronin. Daniel McCarthy. Dean O'Grady. Tommy Porter. Certificate in Quality Management, Tools and Techniques in Practice. Elaine Archer, Neil Boland, Stephanie Devine, Aisling Fitzgerald, Gerardo Fuschi, Swan Hegarty, Katie Hogan, Nigel Houlihan, Tina Lynch, Michael Malone, Diego Milanovic, Sandra O'Neill, Joanne Riley, Nina Reinbold, Charlene Rooney, Bobby Smith, Christine Walsh. Certificate in Mechatronics. Paul Walsh, Michael Dennehy, Christopher Donovan, John Dunn, Christina Fahey, Alan French, John Foley, Trevor Gannon, Perwemlauslaw Guada, Stephen Hannafin, Alan Hanley, Kieran Kennedy, Sean Leahy, Gillian Lee, Thomas McGillicuddy, James Meaney, Robert Murphy, Fionn Murray, Vincent O'Brien, Noel O'Connor, Daniel O'Donovan, Kevin Preston, Cormac Phillips, Brian Stack, Shane Stack, Patrick Stokes, Michael Sweeney. Certificate in Industrial Instrumentation and Automation. Slawomir Andrej Kajskowski. Niall Behan. Kevin Blake. Rory Buckley. Don Carmody, Jeff Cole, Mark Call, Alan Corcoran, Jordan Cosgrove, Mark Cunningham, Lawrence Devery, Frank Doherty, Shane Gavin, Ian Gunn, Michal Harrington, Brian Hayes, Gerard Hayes, Michael Hayes, Donald Heafy, Richard Kelly, Patrick Lawson, John Lenehan, Brian Lucet. Gary McNamara, TJ Maher, Leon McAvoy, Preston McAvoy, Stephen McGoldrick, Brian McHale, Patsy Murphy, Paul Nangle, Philip Noonan, David O'Brien, John O'Callaghan, Donico D, John O'D, Rysard Piatic, Conrad Pychuk, Darius Piskorowski, Gerard Roach, Harry Cecil, Kieran Stack, David Thompson, David Walsh, Jason Ward. A certificate of completion, agricultural mechanics phase 6. Kieran Baverstock. Eugene Burke. Joseph Butler. David Byrne. Sean Kern. Martin Donoghue. Patrick Duggan. Owen Dunphy, Kevin Foley, David French, Alan Fushin, Owen Gainey, Liam Gibbons, Jason Gillian, Ian Gorman, Pierce Goss, Michael Hardiman, Evan Hickey, Kieran Hogan, Gerard Kennedy, Brian Kenny, Jamie King, James Lenehan, Stephen McCann, Timothy Metcalf, Gerard O'Brien, Donal O'Connor, Ian O'Connor, Colm O'Neill, Liam O'Shea, Dermot O'Sullivan, Eric O'Sullivan, Aina Power, Brendan Kwan, Jason Rabbit, Gary Redmond, Colm Sheehan, Andrew Strong, John Sweetenham, Michael Tully, Thomas Williams, now come time for the postgraduate awards. I now present the following postgraduate candidate for the award. President, I ask you to confer on behalf of Quality and Qualifications Ireland the award of Masters of Engineering by Research to Trevor Murphy. His thesis is titled The Design, Test and Evaluation of a Sensing System for Process Analytical Technology, and he's accompanied by his supervisor, Dr. Joseph Walsh.
Thank you, Pat. I now ask Dr. Michael Hall, Head of Department, Health and Leisure Studies, to call graduates who are to be conferred.
Uktaran, Tugendich, Nahira Hori, Shaw, Lannis, School, Narik, and she saw the Hashtis, Kamena, August Marshjok, D, Colleen to Aku, Ismail Toshe, Tilcha Aku, Nadav Akhtani Shaw, all. President, I present to you the following candidates who have successfully completed the requirements for degrees and masters and who are worthy to have these awards conferred upon them. Bachelor of Science in Health and Leisure, Declan Barnacle. Jarlath Bell. Lana Bradley. Leah Broderick. Carl Brown. Orla Condon. Dylan DeBurka. Kaylee Hopkins. Irinas Matsarek. Owen McCrahan. Robert McGovern. Ethan McGrath. Jane McGrath. Jamie Monaghan in absentia. Ronan Monaghan. Shane Nolan in absentia. Cliona O'Connor. Emily O'Grady. Sean O'Reilly. Caitlin O'Sullivan. Natasha O'Sullivan. Thomas O'Sullivan. Raymond Outram. Michelle Parker. Catherine Quinn. Dennis Sheehan. Dean Sinnott Mullins. Lee Walsh. Joseph Weir, both in absentia. Bachelor of Science Honours in Health and Leisure Studies, Stephen Birmingham. Fergal Carey. Cian Cunahan in absentia. Gavin Crowley. Niamh Duffy. Cathal Fennessy. Kelly Gorman. Karen Kennedy. Connor Lowney. Owen Mara. Claire Moynihan. TJ Milan in absentia, Connor Murphy in absentia, Andrew Nagel in absentia, Shane O'Brien, Connor O'Driscoll, Brendan O'Mahony, Clive O'Sullivan. Shane Reynolds. Owen Roach. Jason Tehan. Bachelor of Science in Health and Leisure with Massage. Kelly Burke in absentia. Kyle Bustard. Stephen Cahill. Gemma Griffin. Philip Lyons. Kevin Murphy in absentia. Laura Murphy. Nicole O'Sullivan. John J. Pryor in absentia, Ray Wall. Bachelor of Science Honours in Health and Leisure with Massage, Jeffrey Adley in absentia, Emer Bennett in absentia, Annie Cooper, Roisin Hall. Sinead Hochter. Aisling Miklas. Michelle Mulligan. Amy O'Connell. And in absentia, Eric Van Gosch. Bachelor of Science Honours in Sports Development, Carla Behan. Meg Holland. Gavin Lynch, in absentia. Oisin Moran. In absentia, Pádraig O'Shea, in absentia. Bachelor of Science Honours in Health and Leisure, in athletic performance. Jake Healy. Akeem Malloy. Darren O'Sullivan. Robert Purcell. Bachelor of Science Honours in Physical Education, Christopher Dunn. David Ebbs. Sean Finley. Aaron Kerwin. Tig Linehan. Stephanie Nixon. Clodagh O'Halloran. Bachelor of Science Honours in Adapted Physical Activity, Magella Brown. Monica Ziran. Raymond Kennedy. Kate Mannix. Sinead McElligott in absentia. Sinead Miley. Susie O'Shea. Adrian Scanlon in absentia. Master of Science in Adapted Physical Activity Leadership, Mary Kennefic. Bachelor of Arts in Outdoor Learning, Kieran Byrne. Simon Byrne. Vicky Guy. Owen Halliday. Kieran Lennon. Joe McCarthy. Lorcan MacDonald. Michael Melia. Paul Norris. Ronan O'Connor. And Sebastian Tretter. And ladies and gentlemen, can I just take 10 seconds to acknowledge the occasion of our colleague Elizabeth Brunton's last conferring ceremony. She was here at the beginning of the Health and Leisure Department, and she retires this January. President, I now present the following postgraduate candidates for their Master's Award. I ask you to confer on behalf of Quality and Qualifications Ireland the award of Master of Science by Research to Lucy Cush, whose thesis, Designing and Evaluating the Impact of an Inclusive Aquatics Training Programme for Aquatic Tutors and Teachers. Lucy can't be here today. Her award will be collected by her supervisors, Supervisor Miss Eileen Sayers. Master of Science by Research, Diana Isaac. Her thesis is the investigation into the effects of the UPSI device on cognitive, social and physical development of young children with Down syndrome. Her supervisors are Ms. Ursula Barrett and Ms. Gerard O'Carroll. Master of Science by Research in Absentia for Jerome Selvaraj. His thesis was on the Ernie Els Game On Autism Golf Programme for Young People with Autism and Interpretive and Phenomenological Analysis. His award will be collected by Miss Adele Randalls and Dr. Jackie Gallagher, his supervisors. And Master of Science by Research for Dominic Verkamp, whose thesis, Golf Access for All, an analysis of golf clubs from a universal access perspective towards the development of case studies of good practice and guidelines for best policy and practice. Dominic's supervisors are again Ms. Adele Randalls and Dr. Jackie Gallagher. And last but not least, we move on to awards conferred by Quality and Qualifications Ireland. It is with great pleasure that I present the following participants who successfully completed a three-year programme entitled Skills for Life, which was delivered by St. John of God's on our South Campus. So, certificate in Skills for Life, St. John of God Services. Our first candidate is Seamus McCarthy. Next candidate is Mr. Owen O'Sullivan. Our third candidate is Ms. Jessica Power. I would like to acknowledge the staff of St. John of God's and the staff of the Institute of Technology and the students who support these students as they complete their studies. Congratulations to all and enjoy your day.
Thank you, Michael, and I'd just like to add my voice again to the great support from the John of God's people, but also from the staff and from the students of the Institute who have helped those students through their journey. So that completes the conferring of awards for the Departments of Science, Engineering, Technology and Maths and for the Department of Health and Leisure Studies. I would now ask you to give a round of applause to all the graduates and all the other graduates who also conferred today. So to round off proceedings today, I would like to invite, we have a guest speaker here this afternoon for you who will speak of what is probably his personal career, but also maybe we'll touch on the career of his company. The man's name is Edmund Harty, and he's Chief Executive Officer of Dairy Master. And I was just talking to Edmund briefly before today's event. When I started in the Institute back in a time when certainly I was in a different role and maybe a simpler role, I was taking students out to Dairy Master, and at that point I think they had 38 employees. I think I remember the first year I went out there, and I think today they have 350. So over that period of time, that company has expanded enormously from what probably was a Munster-based company at that stage with his dad, and now is an international company with its headquarters in North Kerry, but also has offices in Birmingham and in the United States. And the Dairy Master Company, I think, would be remiss not to acknowledge the great support that they have been to what was Tralee RTC and then became Tralee Institute of Technology over the years, both in terms of support for anything we ever asked for, taking on students and work placement, taking on graduates of the programme, and now very much involved in terms of building the research capacity of the Institute, and I'd just like to acknowledge that. Edmund is adjunct professor at UCD, which was awarded in recognition of his contribution to the dairy industry. He's also a fellow of the Institute of Technology, Tralee. And he was presented in 2012 with the International and overall Ernst & Young Entrepreneur of the Year Award, which is a fantastic achievement for his company. Edmund is a mechanical engineer by profession. He's with Dairy Master. Since he joined Dairy Master, but I think he was probably joined from the hip with Dairy Master as he was born into it, but certainly became back to his own company in 1998 while he was studying for a PhD in UCD. He's a member of the International Organization for Standardization and the International Dairy Federation, the foremost scientific groups in milking globally. He pioneered a number of new products and has over 40 patents filed to date as a result of work on product development with devices ranging from vacuum regulators and electronic milk metering to the state-of-the-art and animal feeding systems. And again, just from my own observations over the years, I suppose what really is unique about this company is that they make virtually everything in Ireland, which is a fantastic achievement. And I just at this point just ask you to put your hands together and give a warm welcome to Professor Edmund Harty.
President, staff of the Institute, graduates, and ladies and gentlemen, it's a great honour and a privilege to be here today and to extend my sincere congratulations on this significant milestone in your life. Thank you for the invitation to join you on this very special day. Today is about recognising your academic achievement in obtaining the relevant qualifications in your chosen disciplines, and there is a huge amount of those here today. Your graduation ceremony, it's a very special occasion. It's a time of celebration. It's a testament to your personal commitment and to your pride. You've all worked very hard to get here to this day, and you know your work, it will not go to waste. It's a time to think back and to celebrate the perseverance, the sweat, and maybe even sometimes the tears that went into the hard work that brought you here. You will leave here today with friendships and with memories that are going to absolutely last you a lifetime. You've worked hard and contributed most to your success. However, there are a lot of very proud people here today and others who perhaps cannot be here that have helped you in getting this far. Not only have your friends and staff of IT Tralee, there's likely your parents, your families, people who have known you since your childhood, watching you grow, helping and guiding you forward. Therefore, today is a day for them as much as it is for you. Graduation is not an end goal in itself. It's indeed a part of the larger journey of life. It's about looking forward to the start of a new chapter, opening a door into the world of work or indeed postgraduate study, with the various joys and responsibilities that go along with those. It was 21 years ago when I sat at my graduation, and never did I think that many years later would I be standing here addressing the next generation of talent and inspiring them to think about the future and where they can go. There was no smartphone, no Twitter, no Facebook, no Google. They're now part of our daily lives. In my own life, there are many changes too, now that I look back. I'm married, I have two children, and they're a great inspiration in life. But in addition, you know, as was mentioned, I'm the CEO of Dairy Master. And looking back, you know, at the last 21 years, it gives a huge degree of satisfaction. Thankfully, we've many customers around the world. We've had a great buzz creating some fantastic technology, filing a huge number of patents, in fact, over 100 at this stage, and many, you know, winning many of the best awards for business, innovation, and so on. And I would say we also have a great team of people in the organisation, and it's great to see some of those here today as well. But we're only getting started. Our vision is to be the world's most dynamic, innovative, and customer-focused dairy technology company. And we're building a company where we will work together to make a better future for our customers, our employees, and the company. My role is about steering the ship, ensuring that we have the right team on board, and along with the team, it's about navigating the course, figuring out where we should go and how to get there. I've had the opportunity to meet people from all walks of life in many parts of the world, from presidents to sheikhs, princes and princesses, political leaders, business people, innovators, creators, and people who are doing some amazing things in the world, some of which you will know, some of which happen behind the scenes, but are responsible for huge changes in society. Looking back now, I could have never planned it, and believe there are still so many exciting things and adventures ahead. So you might ask, well, how did all this happen? A lot of it happened because of a few simple things which I believe have stood the test of time, despite all these changes that have happened in the intervening years. The first word of advice I would give is to become skilled at something that you love. Ensure you and your team like what you do. If you do it, the chances are you'll be good at it. You'll continually learn new things. If you have the opportunity to work in this area, then working is easy, and you look forward to each new day. And while our technical skills are really important, the real leadership and success comes from how we interact with others. And this is my second word of advice. It's about being aware of others, communicating effectively, motivating and providing inspiration, taking the time to recognise the diversity of thought, differing viewpoints, other ideas, and the importance of how you will bring all this together. These are the skills you won't necessarily learn from textbooks, but through life experience. You can be the most skillful player on the pitch, but it takes a great team to win a game. And to bring everyone on the journey is very important, because everybody has unique skills. The third word of advice, or the third bit of advice I will give you, is that the journey, it's not always easy. It's not always smooth. It's like a boat sailing on the ocean or a car driving along the road. Often you can be sailing away or driving along with life. And then sometimes, suddenly, and sometimes unexpectedly, there can be turbulent times or bumpy roads. And these can be small things, or in fact they can be major life events. It can be at work or at home, it can be with family or it can be with health, and not everything goes smoothly. The advice I would give you is don't get frustrated, keep cool, be positive, even in the face of adversity. Don't see obstacles as stop signs, see them as challenges to get around. Don't let the hassles in life get the better of you or let negativity upset you. Don't think about problems, think about solutions and get on with them. The most important thing here is resiliency. If the water is too deep to swim in, seek help. Focus on the things that matter. Steer the ship away from the choppy waters and to the calmer shores. Remember, many of the things that bother us today, they won't matter next week, not to mind next month or next year. So focus on the things that matter. The challenge and the opportunity for you now as graduates of IT Tralee is to absolutely go forward and succeed. Success is not a destination, it's a journey. It's a story of life. You must continue to learn, continue to listen, continue to better yourself, and indeed the world around you. Receiving your parchments today is not a signal at the end, but rather the beginning of a lifelong, exciting, educational journey. Many of you will become leaders in your chosen fields, and I am confident that you will make very worthwhile contributions to your families, your communities, your organisations, and indeed the world at large. And I would say this to you, the world is absolutely your oyster. enjoy the moment, celebrate today, look forward to the future. Well done, and thanks very much.
Thank you, Edmund. And it's just interesting that Edmund just referred there to smart technology. I just got a text from the back of the hall to straighten my gown. I think my mother turned 80 there recently. She's obviously started to outsource some of the functions. So, ladies and gentlemen, the formal ceremony is now at an end. Finally, let's offer a very deserving congratulations and applause to all your families and guests who are beaming here with pride. To the people who came here as students and are leaving today as graduates, we again offer you our hearty congratulations. As Edmund says, education is probably like, you know, your career is it's a journey, not a destination. And hopefully some of you we will see you again. I know some of you already have come back to the Institute to do add-on degrees and what have you. But also the Alumni Association that we've just started here last year are around the foyer there. So please link up with them. It's very important, both from yourself but also from the Institute perspective, because it's very important for us to know what our students are doing, because it helps us develop our own programs going forward. I would just like to express a few thanks to a number of people and individuals. Firstly, I'd like to thank Ms. Susan Foley Cave on my right, who's the sign interpreter for today. Sirona Strings for the music. The staff involved in the organising of today's event, which was primarily the student services team, but all the support staff in the Institute always fall in on graduation day and go over and above to make the event a success, and particularly to Mairead Enright, who is the leader of the pack, as it were, and I think has got today's event off again to a great success. Thank you. So, finally, to wish you to enjoy the rest of your evening. I know you're all anxious to take your parents out on the tail for the evening, and they're equally as anxious to go with you. So just take care of one another, and again, be aware of social media, and make sure you keep your gown straight. Okay. Thank you very much.